Hi friends, this is Ketan here from KTech Show. So today we are going to talk about 5.1 channel home theater system Sony ST-IV300. It's a 1000 watt home theater system. It's priced at around 21,000 in India. If you are trying to improve your daily TV watching experience, then this is the option that you should choose. This home theater system connects directly to the set-top box and give you a great TV watching experience. While buying this home theater system, I was considering Yamaha YST196, which is an entry level STIB from Yamaha. And I visited Reliance Digital store for listening quality of both the system. I felt Sony at price range of 22,000, it feels better than YST196, which is priced at around 27,000. Also, the size of YST196 AV receiver is very huge compared to this one. But if you are a complete music lover, you can just try all the settings in YST196 and test the music quality and go for it. Okay, so coming to ST-IV300, it's a very easy to set up 5.1 channel 1000 watt home theater system. It is having very stylish look. There are two HDMI ports which can easily connect to one DTH box and any other device like Blu-ray player or any gaming device. And there is one output HDMI port which will go to your TV. HDMI out is ARC, it's audio written channel. So just check if your TV is supporting ARC on HDMI in. Otherwise, you need to use optical input for your TV for 5.1 channel audio input. It has one optical and one coaxial audio input. It is recommended that you use digital audio input if you are just expecting 5.1 effect in your speakers. Home theater is having a USB input which can be used to watch movies, images and listen music files. It has a wireless connectivity via NFC, then Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is mainly used to listen songs via SongPal. It's a Sony app for music. Bluetooth and NFC connectivity works smoothly. Apart from all these inputs, there are speaker connections. There are six speaker inputs provided at the back of the AV receiver, which are color coded, and each speaker can be connected into it. So it's a very easy setup for this home theater system. Talking about the design of this home theater, it's a very stylish, good looking home theater. It is having five satellite speakers in a hexagonal shape. And these speakers is having a mirror-like finish on two sides, which looks very great. Satellite speakers are having a metal grills on it. The main unit AV receiver is also well designed and it's very shiny and good looking. The display on the AV receiver is very small, but you have to rely on actual TV display for the rest of the things. Remote control of the system sometimes feels very bulky as it packs with multiple features. It can control your TV as well as home theater systems in some ways. If you are using a Sony TV, then that would be a good thing that to be used with this home theater system, as you can use Bravia Sync to control your TV and home theater systems simultaneously via one remote. Let's talk about the performance of this system. So I have tried DTH movies. I'm having a SD connection at my home and I've just tried YouTube videos. I've tried USB audio and video files with 5.1 channel movies and they are all sounded very great. If you are just expecting the real 5.1 output, then you need to have a 5.1 input for the system, so you can just have 5.1 channel movies like Blu-ray movies, or you can just have a SD connection for DTH box, and just check with your the DTH subscriber if it is providing a 5.1 channel output or not before buying this system. In this home theater system, there is a mode called Clear Audio Plus, which automatically converts your 2-channel audio to 5.1 channel audio. It's bit good, but not that good compared if you are providing a 5.1 channel input to this system. There are some other modes in this music system, but they are not capable of converting 2-channel to 5.1 channel output. This music system is very loud. Bass is a bit on a higher side. There are no equalizer settings provided in this music system. So that's a bit of a disadvantage I can just see over here. Audio output loses clarity at the high volumes. If you are having a silent room and a good 5.1 channel input, then that is really good to listen music and other movies on this system. There are some speaker settings in the system which are configurable. Like you can just set up speakers at the front and you can just set up speaker at 5.1 channel means at the front and at the back. So you can just control via settings. Then there are settings to configure volume of each speaker that are provided. This can be used to reduce the bass of the system, and let's say if you want a more surround sound, then you can just increase that. Try to arrange the speakers in 5.1 channel layout so that to have a theater like experience at the home. I've already made a conceal connection for surround speakers. So Sony guy just connected those wires to this home theater system. I've just tried to hide all the wires for this music system by just doing a conceal connection, and the rest of the wires are behind my TV. So the conclusion, it's a really good home theater system with 1000 watt output. It has a number of good connectivity options like Bluetooth, NFC, Wi-Fi. It is very loud. It is having a stylish look and design. Then it can connect directly to the DTS set-top box and one more any other input like Blu-ray player or any gaming device. And some of the disadvantage, it's having a bit of overpowering bass, no equalizer settings for it. Then audio output loses clarity at high volumes, and wireless mirroring sometimes doesn't work. Not a big disadvantage, but remote control is sometimes confusing. So that's it. If you are looking for a easy to set up 1000 watt music system at price range of 21,000, then this is a very good option for you. But if you are a complete music lover, then I would suggest you to go for Yamaha or Onkyo or Pioneer entry level systems. Thanks for watching this video. Do subscribe to my channel and hit like button if you just find this information useful for you. Yeah, thanks. Bye.